Okay, is someone sitting here? There's nothing here. Where are the spoons? There's no spoon here. Someone sitting here. How many? It's supposed to be eight. Eight. Okay, so move this a bit. Any knife? Where's the have a proper glass here? No knife here. Can I have a knife here? Have a okay, so there are no glasses here. There are no glasses. Water glass and spoons. There are no spoons as well. There's no spoon here, yes? So check the ones there as well. Yeah, there are no spoons here. Blessing, blessing. There are no spoons here. Here, here. They need the spoons. There are no spoons here. And then there was someone that didn't have a knife here. No wine glasses. Some of them don't have water glasses here. What you can do for me, yeah? So just bring things down, see them like this. This is supposed to be like above the fork. So just so it's in front of the seats. How many are here? One, two, three, four. Fork, knife, spoon. There's not. Napkin. So even here, so just so exactly, so they're in front of the table. So you can't tell. So this has, so there's no fork here. Nothing here. this doesn't have any. So we need knife is setting for this person here. Yeah, there's nothing. No fork, no knife, side plate. Fork, knife, side plate, everything for this person.
Yeah, we need to hurry. Hello. Hello. Okay, we're about to start this August event. Who is the MC? Me? Who is the MC? Who? I can't laugh. Who is the MC? Pelu, DMC. Let's go. Me and you too.
Take you what about that? That kind of thing.
Hello. Are we ready, admin? Are we ready? The children are coming down now. Who is the MC? Start calling.
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
This is for dessert.
like Suya. I'm one no big dog, but it's do ya. Tire so breezy, oh, breezy, oh. You dey dance like breeze, breezy, oh, easy, oh. I'm on my wrist, they go, they freeze, oh. They know they call me Mr. Money for no reason, oh. I see. Shot Santi Jamo, Colorado, pass me the fatty jungle. Piano, piano, it's a big vibe, but the girl them know. Steadily, steadily, heavily, I'm a piano, piano, it's a big vibe, but the girl them know. Steadily, steadily, heavily, heavily. Yeah, what you call? How can you get on? Bad bitches,
what you
want to say? Tell me up, yeah, carry on. She can kind of ban, but you don't call it on.
Kill the music!
Put them on their toes, on the loop, the guy them know. My baby short and Santi Jamo, Colorado, pass me the fat jumbo.
Okay, 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 okay
I want all students seated. Don't stand about. Everyone seated. All right, girls, come. Here, don't let me repeat myself. Next group. Next group, please remain seated. If I see anyone standing, you will go on your knees. Come here, guys. Next group. Mo Daddy. Where's Mo Daddy? Now, we're here for our formal dining event. And how many of you are joining this event for the first time? First time at the formal dining, Edward College formal dining. Put your hands up. I know some of you that are here for the first time. So normally it's supposed to be a very, very exciting event, okay? And it is formal dining for a reason, because it's a formal event, okay? We have an excellent host in the person of Mrs. Amusho, who would kind of show you how to dine formally, how to dine with kings and queens. Now, the expectation, you listen, okay? We don't want side chatting, side talking, because this is a class, okay? What did I say? It is what? It is, I can't hear you guys. So it's a class. So we expect everything that would happen in your classroom to happen here. No side talk, no side chatting. You focus on the PowerPoint slides and you listen attentively to the presenter. And at all times, whatever she's showing you, kinesthetically, you do. Okay? So she's going to teach you how to use various set pieces, cutlery, glasses, and all that. Now, whatever you're learning, as she demonstrates and she tells you to follow up and do what she's demonstrating, you do same. Okay? Are we clear? Now, we don't want to punish anyone. Okay? So we expect compliance. Okay? As we start, we expect full compliance. No chit-chatting. And that's the reason why we have separated from your friendship groups. Because if you put in your friendship groups, I can imagine someone like Timmy Dere, she'll talk from the beginning of the event to the end. It should be. All right. Okay.
Okay. Also, good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Okay. It's also an opportunity for you to make new friends. Okay? Have conversations with people that are not in your year group. You understand? You will not always have the same people around you all the time. So this is an opportunity for us to mix juniors and seniors. Let's see how you can handle, you know, friendships outside of your peer groups. So do, you know, make the best use of this opportunity that you've been given. Okay? Remember, all things work together for good. God bless you. At this point, I'd like to hand over to Mrs. Amusho. Maybe I should introduce her first. Mrs. Amusho is the owner of an organization called the Etiquette Avenue. So she has always been particular about doing the right thing, you know, good composure, good manners. I'm talking, and they're still talking. Good composure, good manners, you know, how you walk, how you talk, how you, you know, do different things that actually make you stand out in society. You know, so this is the part of life where you learn social skills, all right? You learn skills that will take you far in life. These are, you know, skills that open doors for you when you, you know, you find yourself in, you know, the most unusual places. So please, we want you to pay attention. We have testimonies of students who went through this course at Edgewood College and then went abroad, sent us testimonies about how what they learned really helped them, you know, in various organizations that they worked in. So please pay particular attention. You will go through this course every year until you leave the school. So, you know, don't misuse the opportunity. It will work wonders in your life. So put your hands together as we welcome Mrs. Amanda Amusho.
Cordless mic. Good afternoon. I'm going to refer to you as ladies and gentlemen. So, like Mrs. Phillips. Okay, can we share a word of prayer? You can remain seated. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise. We thank you for the privilege and the opportunity to be here this evening. We thank you for the graduation ceremony that has gone ahead. And we also thank you for this moment. We commit everything we're doing here this evening unto your hands, and we ask that you take perfect control from start to finish, that at the end of this session, we would have every reason to give you all the praise and glory. We give you thanks ahead of what we know you have already done. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Now, my name is Amanda Michon. I run an organization called the Etiquette Avenue. So I'm going to be your facilitator this evening on our formal dining tutorial. But I'd like to get some protocol out of the way. Every year, Edgewood College has this event. And there's so much planning that goes into it from the management team here at Edgewood College. But at the top of it here is someone I know, Mrs. Phillips. She does everything in her power to ensure that this evening happens. There's a lot of planning that goes into it. So before we start, I'd like you to give her a resounding thank you to the director of Edgewood College, Mrs. Phillips. I want her to know that you appreciate everything she's done. That's not good enough. We're not ready to start. I can't hear those of you at the back. Some of us don't seem appreciative. Thank you very much. Now, thank you very much, Mrs. Phillips. And I also do not take it for granted that I'm here every year, whether online, via Zoom, or in person. So, let's get with it. Now, the first thing I will tell you, we are going to run through this session as expeditiously as we can. So the first thing you do once you are seated is to take your napkin and you place it on your lap. Now, if you fold your napkin into two, yes, and then you take the edge, this edge should face you, yes, and just place that on your lap. Everybody do that. And then we're going to sit upright at the table. So we are not slouching. Everyone is supposed to sit upright. Good, I can hear you all adjusting your chairs. And the reason I say you have to sit upright, you need to be as close enough to the table. There must be a distance between your hand and the table, about this. Yes? And so we're going to pretend. Can you all hear me at the back? We're going to pretend that we have a big fat cat sitting on our laps, and we're going to pretend we have a mouse at the back. So if you sit back, you're squashing the mouse. And if you lean forward, you're squashing the cat. So that helps you to sit upright. Are we there? Do we all have our napkins on our laps? Yes? And then we're all sitting upright. Okay. Now, what is dining? Dining is an art, a useful skill that never goes out of fashion. Learning and perfecting this skill requires lots of practice. They say practice makes perfect. Yes, so beyond today, when you go home, I would say practice, practice, practice. Okay, so what is dining etiquette? That's why we're here. Etiquette is the proper way of doing certain things, the proper way to act and behave and to comport yourself in any situation you find yourself. So there's etiquette for everything we do. There's etiquette for being in the kitchen. There's etiquette for while you're at school. There's etiquette for dining. What is dining etiquette? Dining etiquette is the code of behavior that one should observe when dining formally or informally. Dining etiquette is at its best when all table manners are observed. So you can either dine formally or informally. So today, the reason you're all dressed the way you are is because we are dining formally. When you're dining informally, it's like when you go to KFC or you go to McDonald's, or you go to Tantalizers and you get food to eat, that's informal. But today, this is very formal. So what does it mean to dine informally? Dining informally means there are no particular rules or conventions to follow. In other words, dining is casual and relaxed. That means if you're going to KFC, you can wear your jeans and t-shirt, but not today because we're dining formally. You can dress in casual clothes, like I just mentioned. You can sometimes eat with your hands, depending on your meal. Who can tell me? Someone just raise your hand and tell me what kind of food you can eat with your hands. Okay, Evan, soup, but something casual. Chicken, yeah, what goes well with chicken? Fries, exactly. Fries, chicken, you can get that at KFC, and you don't have to dress the way you're dressed. You can dress casually. You must observe table manners, but you will not be forced to observe the stricter rules when it comes to dining. Like I just said, you can go to KFC and hold your chicken with your hand, and you can hold your fries with your hand. But when we're dining formally today, you must use your cutlery pieces that have been provided for you. So what does it mean to dine formally? It's more or less the opposite of what it is to dine informally. So dining formally means there are a set of rules that you must observe before, during, and after. So the food hasn't come yet, but I told everyone to adjust and sit upright. Those are one of the rules. I told everyone to place their napkins on their lap. That's another rule. Okay, so there are some rules that happen before. There are some rules that are going to take place while you're dining, and there are some rules that are going to take place after we're done with dining. You dress formally and not casually. Everyone has made an effort. Please give yourselves a round of applause. You all look lovely this evening. Observe proper table manners. We are going to look at what we mean by table manners. We're not going to eat with our hands. I mentioned that. And you must be on your best behavior. So far, so good. Next slide, please. Okay, what are table manners? Table manners are the rules that govern the way we eat. Different cultures have different rules for table manners, and some are stricter than others. Now, table manners, there are a list of them. I'm going to run through them very quickly, just in case those of you in front can't see. Sit upright in your chair. Can we adjust? Is anyone slouching? If you know you've gone this way, make the adjustment. Place your napkin on your lap and not around your neck. How many of you have seen people put their napkins around their necks before? Yes, yeah, sometimes I even see that happen in movies. And because we see that in movies, we think it's right. It's not right. When you're dining formally, you place your napkin on your lap. However, when you're dining informally, there's some very messy foods that you can eat that might be okay for you to put your napkin around your neck. Can anyone tell me? Messy casual food? You said salad, okay. Soups, yes, but let me give you one. Ribs. How many of you have ever eaten ribs in barbecue sauce? It can be quite messy, but that's informal, and you can actually place your napkin up there. So don't slurp on your drinks. Who knows what that is? When you have a drink and you go, let me do this. This is not proper, but I just need to demonstrate. You go, that's raw. Yes? If you have a little drink in your glass, or you drink, once you're done, just place your glass back on the table. We don't need to hear that sound. Okay? So do not make noise with your cutlery and your plate. Because we're using our cutlery pieces, some people can be quite noisy. You need to be a little bit careful with that. Chew with your mouth closed and only place bite-sized portions in your mouth. Now, this is very, very important. Bite-sized portions means a small bite piece that you can put in your mouth, close your mouth comfortably and not struggle. So if you put food in your mouth and I turn around and look at you, I don't need to see this. Because you have placed too much in your mouth. Yes. So bite-sized portions. Yes, small portions in your mouth. Okay, quickly. Do not stretch your hand across someone else's plate, the other side. And I'll show you what I mean. I'm sitting down. I want to get something, and then I'm stretching up someone's plate. It's not proper, because what happens is you have your arm over someone's plate, and the plate has got food in it. So that's not proper. What you just say is, excuse me, if you're trying to reach for something on the table, maybe your salt and pepper shaker or something, you just say, could you please pass? And that would be brought to you. Yes, so don't stretch your hand someone else's plate. I just need to run through one of this and I'll be right back. Okay, so talk about pleasant things at the table. Who can tell me what is considered a pleasant thing? Yes?
And if something does choke while eating, that's not proper.
That's not proper. Okay. What kind of conversations can we have at the table?
Politics.
You're a politician. You're not a politician. Okay. Politics, people can argue, oh, I support the party, I support that party. Yes, but it could get out of hand. So usually discuss things that everybody gets along with. Yeah, pleasant things. And you don't talk about unpleasant things at the table. For example, you are not going to talk about, oh, how your friend fell down and had a terrible wound and what the wound looks like. You're not going to talk about that at the dinner table. Why? Because we're eating. Yes? So be pleasant things at the table when it comes to conversation. Then the last point here, do not wipe across your mouth with your napkin. Now, what do I mean by that? Yes, your napkin is meant for you to dab across, and I hope you can see me coming to the middle. So when you pick up your napkin, if you have food on your lip or something, you wipe. You're going to open half your napkin. You don't go this way. That's wrong. Yes? You don't wipe across. What you do is you just bend your finger in and you dab. That's the proper thing to do. So you're not going to go wiping across your mouth. You dab. What do I say you do? You dab, exactly. So when we start eating, I'm going to come around and see what everyone is doing. Next slide, please. Now, that's a formal table setting. That might look very complicated, but I'm going to break that down for you. Don't worry about the fine print. Now, can all of you see that up there? If you are facing a screen. Yes, if you need to turn, please turn. If you can see the screen. But what I'm saying, you just need to see parts. Don't worry. All the knives, when it comes to formal dining and table setting, all the knives are to the right-hand side. With the exception of your butter spreader. It's a small knife on your left-hand side. In your side plate. Can you all see it? Yes, I've seen it. So not everyone might have a butter knife on their plate, but if you do, you can show it to everyone on the table. So that usually is sitting in your side plate. Your side plate is to the left-hand side. So all your knives are to the right-hand side, if you take a look at the screen, and all your forks are to the left-hand side, with the exception of two forks. If you look at the extreme right, there's a tiny fork that is sitting in the spoon. That is called a cocktail fork. It's usually a very small fork for if you are served something like a cocktail. Now, if you look above you, above the plate, there's another fork there. Now, that is your dessert fork. It's not on the table right now. That will be brought on when it's time for dessert. Yes? So see where your dessert fork and spoon are? It's right above the plate setting. Can you all see it? Yes. So to the top right-hand side corner is where you have all your glasses. So ideally, your glasses should be on the right-hand side, where you have your water glass, your wine glass. Don't worry, we're not having any wine, but we shall be having sparkling fruit, non-alcoholic juice today. We'll use that for a toast. So all your glasses are to the right-hand side. Then, of course, later on, I mentioned the salt and pepper shaker. Can you see them? Now, if someone asks you, could you please pass the salt? You pass the salt and the pepper together. It's believed that they are married, so you don't separate them. So if someone asks you, could you please pass the pepper shaker, you pass the salt as well. So you must always pass both of them together. Yes? Next slide, please. Okay, how to hold your cutlery. Now, we're going to be starting with soup today. So I'm going to show you, first of all, with your knife and your fork, and then I'll show you how to use your spoon. So I'm going to turn around so you can see me. So my fork is held in my left hand and my knife in my right hand. Yes, my fork in my left hand. Do you have a question? Sorry? You can still hold that in your left hand. He says, what if you are left-handed? Don't worry, I'm going to take questions. But in the meantime, just so we're making good use of time, I'm going to ask the caterers to please go around and place the bread rolls on the side plates. I'm going to ask the caterers to place the bread rolls on the side plate and get ready to serve the soup. Thank you. So you can start doing that so we can move expeditiously. Now, the fork is held in your left hand and the knife in your right hand. Now, I need you all to look up here. I'm going to say this here, and I'm also going to move to the middle so as many of you as I seated can see me. So you place your forefinger on the back of the fork like this, if you can all see me, yes. And your knife is also, your forefinger is also placed just on the spine of the knife. Just where the handle of the knife is separated from the blade. Just here. Not like this. This is not right. And this is not right. You move it down just this way and this way. So I'm going to move forward. Now, these are called the tines of the fork. You would usually have four of them. These are the tines of the fork. Yes? So you place your forefinger on the back of the fork this way and your knife this way. And ideally, the tines of your fork are facing down onto your plate. Yes? Can you all see me? The tines of your fork would be faced down onto your plate. Yes? So that's how you hold your cutlery. Can I have that image back up, please? So take a look at that. That's exactly what I just demonstrated. Face down. Now, the resting position. When you eat and you want to take a break, rather than hold your cutlery throughout, for example, we can be having a conversation about what we are going to do also when we graduate. Just like some of your mates graduated today, we're having that conversation at the table. So while you're talking about it, you don't just want to keep holding your cutlery in your hand. So you can rest the cutlery just like this. For those of you who can see the image, you just rest your cutlery with the knife placed underneath the fork. And the blade of the knife is inwards. So for those of you behind me, not like this, but like this. The serrated is placed inwards. Can you all see that? Can you all see that? Yes. Can I have that image back up again, please? So that's it. Take a look at it again. So if you want to take a break today, maybe you've had one or two mouthfuls and you just want to rest, you cross your cutlery. Yes? Next slide, please. Now, that is the finished position. When you have finished eating, you bring your cutlery pieces together at 6:30. I'm going to turn around just like this in the center of your plate. Now, we have the English way of doing things and we have the French way of doing things. Now, while the English close their cutlery at 6:30, like what is being shown on the left-hand side, that's the English way, the French do theirs differently. The French have theirs on the side. If I could give that a time, I would say that is 10:20, 20 minutes past 10. So that's the French way of doing things, on the right-hand side, and on the left-hand side is the English way of doing things. So when you're done eating today, I'm going to go around to check, you must close your cutlery at 6:30. Now, when you're in a proper restaurant, what you are doing, when you close your cutlery, you're giving the waiter a sign eating. So he has every right to come and pick up your plate and walk away with it. So when you close your cutlery, what you're trying to tell the waiter is, I'm done eating. Yes? But if you still have food on your plate and your cutlery is this way, resting, or if there's no food on your plate and your cutlery is resting, the waiter is just going to leave your plate because what you're trying to say is, I'm not finished. Okay? So if you're resting, finish. Sorry, take the position. And if you're done eating, take the finish position. So we go with the English style of eating here. So in as much as I've shown you the French way, let's go with the English way at 6:30. Next slide, please. Fantastic. How to eat soup. And I know that your soup is coming out now. I'm hoping that we can move as quickly as possible. Those of you who have your soup already, let me show you quickly how to eat your soup. Now, you have your soup spoon, and please, if you do not have your soup spoon, please raise your hand. One of the waiters or so staff, the catering staff should come to you if you don't have a soup spoon. So please, over here. Over here, some of us need our soup spoons. Their hands are raised, and they're going to stay raised until they get their soup spoons. So please, because they need them for the soup. Okay. So please keep your hands raised so your soup spoons can be brought to you. Now, how do we eat soups? Now, there are two types of soups we can have. We can have soup with condiments. That's how soup you have. You can have little bits of spaghetti in there, or you can have some vegetables in there. Those are soups with condiments. Or you can have a broth. It's just plain. So this is a bowl of soup without condiments. You don't have any vegetables in there. You don't have any beef in there. You don't have any fish inside. It's just plain. It could be a cauliflower soup. It could be a pumpkin soup. That looks like pumpkin soup. So there's nothing in it. Next slide, please. Or you could have a soup that has condiments in it. Take a look at that. It's got vegetables in it. Yes? So we have two different types of soup spoons. The one you have today is the one, it's very sharp. This is the one used for soups that have condiments, so they easily get into your mouth. Yes? Now I'm going to show you how to eat your soup. So I just need you to watch me. I'm going to move to the middle as well. Now, for those of you here, this is what we normally do when we eat soup, and this is not correct. We do this, and we raise to our mouth. This is what we do, but this is not right. What you do is you scoop outwards, and you raise to your mouth. You scoop outwards, and you raise to your mouth. Not this. This is not correct. This is what most of us do. Yes? That's not proper. So you scoop what? You scoop what? outwards. Again, we scoop outwards. So, and before I move to the center, so those at the center can see me, when you eat your bread roll along with your soup, please do not cut the bread roll in half, butter it, and then eat it like a sandwich. No. You take what? Bite-sized portions. So I don't want to see anyone holding their bread roll like you're eating a burger from McDonald's. No. So just take a little bite that you know can go into your mouth. Okay? So bite-sized, that you butter it, put a little butter on it, and that goes into your mouth. So no one should be seen holding their bread roll like a burger. Okay? Going to move to the middle. Okay, so you can see me on the screen. That's good. So I'm just going to demonstrate that again. So you lift your soup spoon and your soup to the edge, and then you raise to your mouth. You lift to the edge and you raise to your mouth. You do not do this. You don't bring it like you're scooping something to it. Instead, you scoop outwards. And when you want to take a break, you just place your spoon in your bowl. When you're ready to continue, you just lift that again. Yes? You scoop outwards and you place. Now, sometimes when you get soup, who can tell me the hottest part of soup? The center or the sides? The center. Thank you very much. The center is usually the hottest. So you usually start with the side. Yes? So that way it goes down nicely. Yes? The side. And then you place to the side of your bowl if you wish to take a break. Don't forget, if you need to dab, you just lift your napkin, bend it over, dab, and then place it back in the same position on your lap. And then it would be a good time to let the children have water in their glasses. So we're just going to use our water glasses for now. So if anyone has any question, you can ask me. Yes? So you scoop. Yes, you have a question? Sorry? How do we eat the bread? You just take a little bite. You break the bread. Just an amount, a piece that you know can fit into your mouth. Like I said, you don't want to be caught with your mouth full of food. That's not proper. And then you're to struggle to eat what you have in your mouth when it's very full. And when you're sitting at the table with other people, it's not a nice sight. It's not something pleasant to see when you're eating, when sitting beside you has their mouth full of food. Yes? So just break a little bit of the bread, put a little butter on it, and place it in your mouth. Yes? Don't forget, you're not cutting, you're not buttering the whole thing, and you're not going to lift the roll like a burger. That's a no-no. Okay, I have another question here.
So eating soup formal and informally are very different, correct?
Well, he's asked a good question, that is there any difference from eating soup formally and informally? My answer to that question is there's just one way of eating soup, and that's the formal way. You scoop outwards and then you raise to your mouth. You scoop outwards and you raise to your mouth. Yes? Go ahead.
I was listening to your attention, but I still am confused how you scoop out your soup and how you place it into your mouth. Do you place the spoon in your mouth while you still have soup whole? Do you scoop the soup out of the spoon, or do you bring it to your mouth and then leave the spoon up to your mouth, and then you eat the soup.
Okay, let me explain that. So when your soup comes, I'm going to come to your table. Yes? So you just put your spoon in the bowl, lift up some soup, and just raise it to your mouth. Yes, you scoop outwards and just raise it to your mouth. Once the soup is in your mouth, you place your spoon back in the bowl. So once your soup comes to your table, I'll come to you. Is that okay? All right. Can I have the next slide, please? So for those of you who have your soup and your bread and butter, please do not forget the rules. You scoop outwards and you lift to your mouth. And when you want to take a break, you just place your spoon back in your bowl. Your bread is bite-sized portions, nothing large, what you know can fit into your mouth. Okay, now let's look at glasses. I mentioned earlier that glasses are placed to the right-hand side, just above the knives. As you can see from the image, they're all on the right-hand side. All your glasses should be on the right-hand side. Now, this is your water glass. So you hold your water glass like you would normally do most glasses. Yes, I hope all of you can see me. You just hold your water glass. Now, any glass you have that has a stem, this is the stem of a glass. Yes, for those of you, I know you can see me on the screen. This is the stem of the glass. So once your glass has a stem, you hold the stem to drink from it. So if your glass has a stem, you are not going to hold it like this. Some of us hold the glass like this, but this glass has a stem, so you hold it at the stem, and then you drink that way. Yes, so you're holding like this, but you are holding for the stem. Now, I know some of you have champagne flutes, so it's good for you to understand that there's a difference between the wine glass and the champagne flute. So in my hand, this is the wine glass. This is a red wine glass. And this is a champagne flute. You can see the difference in the glasses, so at least you know. Wine glass, champagne flute. The champagne flute, of course, is slimmer and it's a longer glass. But you hold both of them at the stem. Yes? Champagne flute, water glass. Sorry, wine glass. Champagne flute, wine glass. Now, thank you. There are some water glasses that look just like this. They're called water goblets. They look just like the wine glass. And so if you have those, you would still hold it by the stem. Yes? Now, what's the reason? Why do they tell you to hold your glass by the stem? If you hold your glass by the bowl, what tends to happen is whatever drink you have inside becomes warm. The temperature in your hand warms the bowl of the glass. So if you have wine in there and you keep holding your glass this way, whatever wine you have in there, the temperature changes. Not that I expect any of you here to be drinking wine, but even your fruit wine, if you have it in the glass and you keep holding it this way, the temperature changes. The warmth in your hands will change the temperature of your drink. So let's be mindful of that. So I hope we're still sitting upright. It doesn't mean because we've started eating. Don't forget, you're scooping outwards, raising your spoon to your mouth, and you're placing it back in your bowl. Your bread, bite-sized portions. Don't forget, no one should cut the bread in half to butter. Please, no. Okay. Today, because they're having a formal dining session, we're dressed for the event, and we're dining to a three-course meal. Who can tell me what the first meal is called? Anyone? A starter. Put your hands together for her. Those of you who still have your hands free. Come on. She knows. She got the answer right. I can't hear you. We can do better than that. Thank you. Thank you. So who can tell me what comes after the starter? There's some of us here who have done formal dining at least twice. The main course, put your hands together for him. No, we're not doing well. It's much better, and we can do a whole lot better than that. The first is the starter, then comes the main meal. Who knows what comes after the main meal? Buddy? Who can tell me? Everyone should be able to tell me what comes after the main meal. What comes after the main meal?
Dessert.
Put your hands together for him. We can do a lot better than that. Should I stop? Okay, let's put our hands together for him. He did well. Thank you. So for a full course meal, for this formal dining session, we have a starter, which you're all having now. We have a main course, and we have dessert. Who can tell me what else we can have as a starter? We're having soup now. Who can tell me what else we could be having as a starter? He said potatoes. Depends on how the potatoes are put together. Anybody else? Yes? Salad. Is that what you said? Please put your hands together for him. That's a good option. Put your hands together. Yes, so we can have salad as an option, or you can have... Today we have chosen soup, just so you can learn how to eat soup properly. Now, who can tell me what we can have as a main meal? Because usually, for a main meal, you would have either fish, chicken, beef. Those are the main parts of a main dish. Beef, chicken, and fish. Now, you will be served a side dish in addition to your beef, chicken, or what's the other one? Beef, chicken, or fish. You would be served a side dish. Now, there's so many options for a side dish. You can have potato, you can have mixed vegetables, or you can have rice. So when you get your main meal today, you can sure to find either potato, rice, mixed vegetable as a part of your main meal. Now, everybody loves dessert. What can we possibly have for dessert? Truffles? What? Trifle? Trifle for dessert, okay? Yes? Ice cream? Anybody on this side? Sorry? Cake? Yes, we can have cake. Brownies? Cube? Anybody else? Apple pie? The list is endless. He says pancakes. Yes, you can have pancakes prepared in a certain way for dessert. Yes, so we have many options for dessert. So I'm not going to ruin the surprise. You would see what you're having for dessert when it does come out. So for those of us who started early with our soup and bread roll, if you're done, just place your cutlery, your soup in the middle of your bowl, like 6:30, just to say you're done. I'm going to show you in a second. So if this is my bowl, this is your bowl, and you're done, just place your spoon in the middle, and that's it. Yes? That's just to say you're done. Place your spoon right in the middle, and you're done. If you are not done, you're still eat. Just place it on the side. Now, I need to mention something very important when you're drinking. When you have food in your mouth, please ensure that you chew and you swallow before you drink. Ensure that you chew your food and you swallow your food before you drink. Because what could happen is, if you don't swallow your food first and you make an attempt to drink, not everyone is skilled in the art of doing that. You could backwash. You know what backwashing means? Let me explain it to you. So while you have food in your mouth, if you don't swallow it and you try to drink, you can have some of that food come into your glass. And that's not proper because you have other people at the table eating. It's a very unpleasant sight. So please, to prevent backwashing, make sure you chew your food, you swallow, and then you drink. Are we all clear? Chew your food, you swallow, and then you drink. And while you're drinking, don't forget, don't slurp on your drinks. We don't want to hear anything like, that is bad manners, especially for the table. Yes? That's poor dining etiquette. So, especially for the ladies, it pertains to everyone in here, but you want to be very elegant when you're dining. The way you hold your glass, the way you lift it up to your mouth, you take your time when you eat. Yes, you don't rush your food. Next slide. Okay, now this says, let's dine. So we've started dining, and I want those of you who are free who can ask one or two questions. I'm ready to take your question. Does anybody have any questions for me? Yes, please. Okay, she's asked a very good question. If we don't want to eat any, what can we do? Now, just close your cutlery. Put your spoon, right now you're having soup, so just place your soup spoon at the center, that way, the other way, exactly. So you just place your soup spoon at the center. If any of you can see this, if the cameraman can zoom in, you done? Are you done? Okay, I'm going to use her soup bowl as an example. So if she's done eating, what I'm going to do is just to close the cutlery this way. So that's it, she's done. So for those of you who need to adjust, make the adjustment. If you're done eating, just close your soup spoon that's in the middle of your bowl. Point, before the evening is over, we're going to have a toast. And I don't know who that would be, but we're going to have at least three of you who are going to share a toast with all of us. So, I don't know who's going to volunteer, but three of you. Now, when that time comes, you're going to have some of your sparkling wine juice in your glasses, in your wine glasses. And we'll raise our glasses for the toast. Now, I need to mention something here. Usually, at events here, when there's a toast, this is what happens. I have my wine glass. I just want to let you know there's a difference. And when it's a casual event, let's just say, oh, for anyone who has graduated today and wants to have a party with friends, I would expect that it would be a casual event. Oh, we're having a party at my house, and so we are going to toast to one another. We've graduated and everyone raises their glass. That would be an informal event. So everyone would raise their glass. I'm going to ask someone to assist me. What's your name? Amira. So I'm going to ask Amira to assist me. So she's going to raise her glass. Now, if this was an informal event, stand up so everyone can see us. Yes? Put your hands together for Amira for volunteering, for agreeing to do this. Put your hands together. Thank you. So if this was an informal event, let's say one of you were having a party after graduation, and we're like, oh, let's toast, you know? So raise your glass. Okay for you to clink your glasses when it's an informal event. So we would go to all of us, and then we would go that way. But when it's a formal event, like this one, this is a formal event, this is a formal dining session we're having, we do not clink our glasses. So what we do is we just raise our glasses. You see what she's doing? If I say, let's raise our glasses to the management of Edgewood College bringing us this far for putting this event together. So we would all raise our glasses and say to the management team at Edgewood College. And you would raise your glass and you can give a little nod. And that's it. Take it and then you put your glass back down. Put your hands together for a mirror. So do not forget, when it's an informal event, can clink your glasses. So let me clink with someone at this table who wants to clink a glass with your wine glass. Yeah, you can lift it. Yeah? That's when it's an informal event. But when it's a formal event, you just raise your glass. And you can give a nod, and that's how we do it. So did we get that? Those of us on this side, when it's an informal event, you can clink your glasses. Anybody at the table? Let's go. Yeah, that's an informal event. But for an event such as this, raise your glass again. Exactly. Everyone at the table will just raise their glass to all of us. Or to whomever you are toasting, just raise your glasses. Yes, take a sip, raise your glass. Yes, fantastic. So I'm coming this way so we can try it. So let me try with this table. If it's a party, we're all just having a party, just fun. So someone raise their glass, their wine glass. Are you done eating? Let me come round. I don't want to cross your plate. So if this is an informal gathering, we can clink our glasses. However, our event today is formal. So what do? We raise our glasses. So everybody at this table, just raise your glass for a second. So if I'm toasting to everyone at this table, we would all just raise our glasses. Everybody? Yes. Whatever the toast is. To Edgewood College, everyone would raise their glass. So no clinking of glasses today. Remember, I know we like the sound when the glasses clink. No clinking of glasses today. So for those of us who have finished with our soup, don't forget to close your cutlery. 6:30, perfect. Yes, and we don't need to use the fork and the knife yet. The fork and the knife is for your main meal. The fork and the knife is for your main meal, please. Yes, you have a question?
So do you use the menu is it? So which spoon are we going to be using?
Okay, that's a fair enough question. When you're done with, you use your soup spoon. So when the waiters come round, they're going to take the soup spoon away and they're going to take your soup bowl away. So you are not going to have your spoon on your table anymore. So for your main meal, you are going to use your dinner knife and your dinner fork. Your knife is on the right-hand side, and your fork is on the left-hand side. That's what you're going to use for your main meal. Now, many of us here use spoons to eat rice. We use spoons to eat many things, to eat lunch, to eat dinner, but you are able to eat your food when you use the right pieces of cutlery. So for your soup spoon, for your soup, you're not going to use a fork, are you? A fork has no bowl. That's why you use a soup spoon. So same thing, when you're trying to get everything straight, if you use a spoon, you might not be able to achieve the best results. So you need the guidance of your fork and your knife. Yes, so please save your fork and your knife for the main meal. Does anybody have any questions? Any questions? I hope we're still sitting, right? It doesn't mean because we have started eating that we should slouch. Everyone should still be sitting upright. So if you're not sitting upright, make the adjustment. Now, don't forget, you don't want to squash the mouse behind you or kill the cat or squash the cat in front of you. So sit upright. Don't forget bite-sized portions. When it comes to eating your main meal, the same rule applies. Bite-sized portions. Okay? Now, I know some of us are done with our starter, so I'm just going to show you how to handle your cutlery for the main meal. Let me get mine. Okay, I have my cutlery here. I have my dinner fork and my dinner knife. Now, depending on what you have on your plate, I know you're going to have potatoes. Can anyone spare a menu? Can I take a look at the menu from anyone? Okay, I have one here. Thank you. Okay, the main meal says jollof rice, chicken in stew, beef stew, and mixed vegetables. Okay. Now, I mentioned earlier that the tines of your fork are faced downwards onto your plate. Can you all see me? So let's assume I have an imaginary plate in front of me. The tines of your fork are faced downwards onto your plate. Now, if you wanted to cut a piece of chicken or beef, this is how you would go. Yes? Don't forget how to hold your knife and how to, I'll take your question in a minute, and how to hold your fork to cut your piece of chicken or beef. Now you have rice. Yes? You have rice. And you can't put rice on the back of your fork. Unless you were eating something like a risotto, which is like a sticky rice that will stay on the back of your fork. But if you put rice on the back of your fork, what's going to happen? If you put rice on the back of your fork and you try to raise it to your mouth, what do you think would happen? Everything is going to fall back onto your plate. So this is how we're going to manage rice that we're going to be served today. Can everyone see me? So this is what we're going to do. You are going to scoop a little rice onto your fork and you are going to raise it to your mouth. So assuming this is my plate, I'm going to put some rice onto my fork and I'm going to put that onto my, and lift that to my mouth. Put some rice onto my fork and lift that. Now you also have vegetables. Yes? So you can have a little rice. You can have a little mixed vegetable, and then you raise your fork to your mouth. But don't forget bite-sized portions. What did I say? Okay, I think it's only those behind me who are paying attention. One of those of you in front of me, bite-sized portions. What did I say? Yes, you did well with the starter, and I know that we're going to do even better with the main meal. So don't forget, you scoop your rice or whatever it is you want to eat onto your fork and you raise to your mouth. But when it comes to cutting your beef or your chicken, don't forget the tines of the fork are faced downwards onto your plate. You cut a piece and you raise to your mouth. Yes? Okay. Now don't forget, if you all want to take a break, forget to cross your cutlery like this. For those of you behind me, don't forget to crush your cutlery like this. And if you wish, if you're done eating, don't forget to close your cutlery English style this way. And for those of you behind me, that's how you close your cutlery, together in the center of your plate. If anybody has any question, you can ask. Okay, yeah, there was a question somewhere. One had a question. Okay, just left. Does anybody have any questions? It's okay for you to have light conversation at the table, not to make any noise. But you can speak to the people on your table. And like Phillips has said, make friends. It's all part of dining. When you get older and you have opportunities to go out to dine formally, whether it's representing your company or whether it's a university or a college event, you might not end up going with your friends. You might be meeting people from different faculties, different companies as you get even older. So you have to learn to make friends and start conversations. Yes, you have to learn to make friends. So I know you have some people, year 7. Do we have year 7th on this table? Do we have year 8th on this table? Do we have at this table? Any 10? Exactly. We have 7, 8, 9, 10. So start a conversation. It's a year 10 here. Yes, I'm sure you can't wait to graduate. Next year you won't be here. Exactly. I'm sure you're happy. Very happy. Exactly. So you can start a conversation. And those in year 7 can't wait to get to year 10. Who is in year 7 here? Yes, I'm sure you can't wait to get to year 10, right? Exactly. So have a conversation at this table. At this table, do we have 10s here? Year 10s? Year 9? Year 10 as well? Year 9? I'm here. Okay, year 8? Yeah, we have a mix at this table as well. Yeah, it's okay. Yes, I know we might not be sitting with our friends, but have a conversation. You can start it. You are year 10. Ask someone a question and everybody join in. Yes, as long as you don't have food in your mouth. Thank you. Now, that reminds me. Of course, we all know we don't talk with food in our mouth. So you make sure you swallow first before you speak to the person. So if someone asks you a question while you're eating, take your time, swallow, and then answer the question. They would be patient enough. They would wait for you to respond. So don't be in a hurry to respond, especially when you have food in your mouth, okay? All right. Now, like I said, it would be nice to move as expeditiously as we can. So if the main meal is ready, I would ask for the main meal to start coming out, please. If the main meal is ready, please let the main meal start coming out. You can start clearing. I know a lot of the starter has been cleared. But please let the main meal start coming out. Thank you. So if the dishes can be cleared quickly, that would help. So who has questions for me? Questions? I have a prize. I have a prize to give away. Who has questions? I want questions, questions, questions. You having any conversation? Do we have year 10s at this table? Fantastic. Year 9? Yes, 8? 7? Everybody's well represented. So where are the year 10s? You? Who else is a year 10? Just her. Just start a conversation. You're the senior at this table. Yeah, say something. Let everyone join you in conversation. A topic you think everybody would be interested in. Yeah, so start something. I'm going to come back and ask you what it is and what you guys are chatting about. So start something. What's the latest movie? What is it? Well, what's the latest movie? Talk about movies. Talk about something that everybody can get involved in. Yeah? you don't have to be with your age mates. As we get older, age doesn't really play the big deal. You can have a boss who is younger than you. You know that. Exactly. So start a conversation and smile. Yeah, so start a conversation, something. Anything. Okay, I'm going to leave you to it, whatever you choose to. So, at this table, we're chatting at this table already. I like this table. Do we have year 8s at this table? Yes, I know you. Year 9? Anybody year 10? So we have year 9, year 8, year 7. Yeah, so year 9. So start a conversation. What are you guys talking about already? You're laughing. What? A movie? What? When you get to year 10? How you can't wait to leave school? 3 plates of food. But you've only had a starter. So how can you have had 3? So I'm glad you guys are having a laugh at this table. It's good. So keep it going. Please, I've observed something. Please, I need the caterer to be aware. Just some people might have sent in their cutlery along with the starter. So please just make sure everyone has their dinner fork and a dinner knife ready for the main meal. So please, can I have someone going round with forks and knives? Can I have someone going round with forks to make sure everyone has their dinner fork and their dinner knife? Some of it might have gone with the starters. So please, you just move around from table to and just ask. Okay, have I been asked what you guys are talking about at this table? Yes, yes, yes. There's nothing to talk about. There's plenty to talk about. Movies, what are you doing this holiday? Exactly. So ask everybody. Everyone must say something about what they plan to do this holiday. If you are going to work, no one is old enough to learn to drive at this table. Yeah, if you're going to work, get a small job, or you're going on holiday, where would you like to go? There's a lot to talk about. So start. I'm coming back to this table. So start. What are you doing this holiday? You have till September, right? There's a lot to talk about. So at this table, I see you guys are having fun as well. What are we talking about? Politics. Politics. Politics and fat people. Hope you're not making fun of fat people. Okay, fine. You have something to talk about. That's fine. If anybody has any questions, I'm going to put questions. I'm going to throw questions out there. And I'm hoping you can remember and answer them. But in the meantime, you need to know that you are having conversation. And like Mrs. Phillips said, you are making new friends. Yeah? So at this table, do we have anyone year 10 here? Year 9? 8? 7? Fantastic. Have year 10s at this table. So start the conversation. Maybe there's nothing to talk about. There's always something to talk about. Example, what does everybody do? You have any plans for the holiday? Travel? Yeah, that's a good one. You? Work? Not yet. Find a little job. Learn. No one is old enough to learn to drive at this table. Not yet. But it's something you could, there are things that you can talk about. Movies, it doesn't matter. We have to learn to interact with people, older, younger. Like, as you get older, let's even say you get into the workforce, you might find out that you're more than you. It does happen. You know that can happen. So yeah, you have to interact. Yeah, so chat. Smile. Chat. It's formal dining. After the event, and go and look for your friends and hang out with them and make the noise that you want to make. But for now, you can chat with the people at your table. Yeah? Year 10. So start something as the senior at the table. A conversation, anything you like that they can flow with. Sorry? You're not interested. Sorry? You're yet to, okay, start something then. Are you, for you first to come. Okay, so relax your hands. When your hands are ready for to start a conversation, either of you. Yes? What's your name? Pretty in orange. Sorry? Conversation, Olive, with the people at your table. Anything. Yeah? Start something. So at this table, what are we doing? Questions, questions, questions. Does that mean you know everything that we've done this evening? Even if it's something that you witnessed somewhere and you're not sure, you want to find out, is this right? Is this wrong? You can ask that question now. Have we started our conversation at this table? Not yet. Please, I would like the food to come out quickly, please. The main meal. Have we started our conversation at this table? Not yet. Start something. I'm relying on you. At this table, have we started a conversation? Anybody in year 10? Year 10? Fantastic. Year 9? Year 8? 7? Year 7. Fantastic. So we have all the year groups represented here. So Check your napkin. Fantastic. Good question. Okay. I have a very good question here. So when we listen to the question and I answer the question, it's the perfect way to learn. So she has asked me, when you get up from the table, where to leave your napkin. So what I would say, the first thing is, if you have to leave the table, what do you think you should do while you're leaving the table? What do you say? Does anybody know? Anybody, if you're leaving the table, if you have to, any reason? No, not that. Thank you very much. He said, can I be excused? So if you have to leave the table, you need to say to others at the table, can I be excused, or excuse me, please. Now, don't forget you have your napkin on your lap. So where do you put your napkin if you're leaving the table? When you're leaving the table, if you need to be excused from the table, where do you leave? Where do you put your napkin?
You fold the napkin.
Well, that would be when you're done eating. When you leave the table, place your napkin on your chair. Okay? You place your napkin on your chair. You lift it off your lap and you place it on the chair. And then when you come back, you lift it from the chair and place it back on your lap. Thank you for having the food come out. We need to move as expeditiously as we can. Thank you. I have another here.
When you want to leave the table, can you be excused?
Yes, you can. If you need to leave the table for any reason, you can be excused. Yes, you just say excuse me and you leave the table. Yep.
So when you're eating your rice, where do you scoop your rice first, your knife or your fork?
Just watch me. So this is your fork, this is your knife. Yeah? So you just put some rice onto your fork, you lift it to your mouth. So make well, and you can take a little rice and just put that on your fork. Not going to heap your fork, just enough to go into your mouth. A little rice, a little vegetable in your mouth. So if you want to cut your chicken, a piece of chicken or piece of beef, you have your fork facing down into the beef, and then you cut a small piece and then you lift your mouth. Or you can cut a small piece and have that and put that on your fork with some rice. Okay? And you lift your mouth. Yes. Questions, questions, questions. For those of us who have received our main meal, I can see you have a question? No, it's coming. For those of us who have received our main meal, I can see we have jollof rice, we have potato, have mixed vegetable, and we have beef. Okay, I have a question over here.
Why do we use the butter knife? Why do we use the butter knife?
The butter knife. The butter knife was used for your bread roll. So that's the small knife. You saw that. So that would have been taken away. So now you're going to use your dinner knife to eat. So let's start. You have your food. Swap your knife and your fork. Your knife is supposed to be in your right hand. Please, can you take the microphone for him? So your knife in your right hand and your fork. So this is what you're going to do. So hold your knife this way. Your knife. Yes. And your fork this way. So what you can do is, see how I'm holding it. If you want to cut a piece of chicken, so turn your knife. Turn your fork. Exactly. Put that in the beef. Yes? Yes. And then a small piece, small, what you know can go into your mouth. Yes. Just put your fork in properly. Yes. Exactly. Like, don't worry. Take your time. You're not in a... Don't rush it. Yes? Okay. Do you mind me helping you with that? Yeah, perfect. So let me just show you. So that's what we're going to do this. I know it's a bit tough. Yeah, let's just say we have that. This is a bit tough. Yeah, this is a bit tough. So I agree. But if you have this, so let's say we have, you want to eat some of the beef and we want to eat some of the rice. So this is what we will be. We just take a little bit of rice, take a little bit of this, and voila. You look back in the back. Yeah? So I'm going to leave you to it. But I understand that the beef is tough, so take your time. Okay, for those of us who have received our main meal, you have some jollof rice, you have some steamed potato, some mixed vegetable, some chicken, and some beef. So don't forget, you scoop some rice onto your fork and you lift to your mouth. You scoop some rice onto your fork and you lift to your mouth. If you have to cut your beef or your chicken, you place the tines of the fork in your, you cut through and you place in your mouth. Or you can have a little bit of everything onto your fork. Don't forget bite-sized portions, please. If we can keep the food coming out quickly. We have about 40 minutes left to vacate the hall. Don't forget, you're not supposed to be speaking with food in your mouth. Make sure you swallow before you. Make sure you swallow first before you respond to any conversation. So please, if you have your food, if you can start eating, that would help. We don't have long to spend in the hall. So please, and you want to enjoy your meal, you received your food, please go ahead and start eating. And don't forget, in the course of your meal, you might need to dab. So don't forget to place your napkin across your mouth, not wipe, just dab. And don't forget, when you're drinking, do not backwash. Make sure you chew your food properly, you swallow, and then you drink. So please, if you've received your food, start eating. If you do not have your dinner knife and fork, please raise your hand. If you do not have a dinner knife and fork, raise your hand. I hope some of you, if you are not eating, you can carry on with the conversations at your table. To ask me, can I show you? Yes, and when I show you, can. Okay. Ready to go. This is how you go. Just have some rice on there, and that's it. So if you want, you can have a little rice, you can have a little vegetable on there. But don't forget, it has to be something that you can put in your mouth. Yeah? You're welcome. And if you want to cut anything, you can go now. I think the beef might be a bit tough, but you can go this way. Just take your time. Might be tough, but... Okay, we have non-alcoholic wines coming on the table. So whatever you put in wine glasses, don't forget we need to leave a little for toast. Yes, so the wine is on your table. When your dessert comes out, it will be opened, and then you can have that ready for the toast. So please, if you have received your food, you can start eating. Don't forget bite-sized portions. I can see some people making good effort here this evening. They're doing very well. Don't forget your wine will be opened, the bottles of wine on the table will be opened once your dessert comes. So you have it ready for the toast. So, doing? There's some people behind me here that are yet to receive their food. Over here. Please, if you do not have a dinner fork or a dinner knife, please signify by raising your hand. And it will be brought to you. Don't forget, bite-sized portions. Some of us are doing very well this evening. And that I was mentioned something. When you're dining, when you're eating, your food comes up to your mouth, your head does not go down to your plate. Yeah, so you lift your food and it comes up to your mouth. You don't put your face down to your plate. Please be careful. Conversations or you are taking a break, crush your cutlery while it's on your plates. Don't just leave it open. Crush your cutlery, and if you're done eating, you close your cutlery at 6:30.
Some people are eating. So if the waiters, if there's one person who comes around and start taking the place to be, because we need dessert. Mrs. Phillips says they have about 30 minutes left. And we must do dessert. So those are finishing. Give a waiter.
So please leave the wine for now, because we all need to have some in our glasses when it's time for the toast. So you can have water with your meals, but make sure you have some of your wine in your glass for the toast.
I'm going to eat?
No.
Because I'm working. Not fair. Well, thank you for thinking about me. Thank you. I hope we're all doing well and we're enjoying our meal. It's almost time for dessert. So don't forget, if you're done eating, close your cutlery at 6:30. Make sure your cutlery is closed in the middle of your plate at 6:30. I hope I have volunteers for the toast this evening. I need at least 3 people to volunteer this evening. Be careful. Be careful. Don't forget, if you're done eating, close your cutlery at 6:30. Your knife and your fork together, the center of your plate, so it can be taken away. Don't forget bite-sized portions. Don't forget to use your napkins as well. Okay, everyone, I hope we're moving through our meals and we're not just chatting, because we have about 20 minutes left and we need to have dessert. Okay, are we done? We're not supposed to be touching our food with our hands. I've seen one or two people. That's why you have your cutlery. So let me ask you quickly, who can tell me what food you can eat with your hands? A Nigerian meal that you can eat with your hands. Anybody? La. You can eat amala with your hands. Can even use cutlery to eat amala, but please, no one should be caught eating rice with their hands or picking their potatoes with their hands. That's why you have your knife and your fork. the waiters can please go around. The waiters, they can go around and collect them. So we can ask for the, yes, so we can ask for the dessert. We have about 20 minutes left here. We have to vacate the hall. So please, if you are done with your meal, close your cutlery at 6:30. It's almost time for dessert, and then we can wrap up the evening. You can go and enjoy your holiday. Can I help you? So what you hold in your phone? Yeah, don't worry. Not embarrassed. Yeah, so do that. Yeah, put your forefinger on the back of the phone. On the back of it. Yeah, press it down. Put some pressure on it. Turn it this way. See, yours is on the side. Do this. Perfect. Exactly. That's how it should be. So put that in the piece. Yeah. Hold that tight. And then a small piece. So what you know can fit into your mouth. Don't worry. Take your time. Practice makes perfect. Yes? So, thank you. Okay, your dessert coming right in another 5 minutes. It's going to be coming around in another 5 minutes. So, do you dessert? Thank you. Okay. The thing is, so put the ice cream. So, yes, once you are ready, we'll start going out. So you will be coming out in 5 minutes. So I want to be able to wrap up so we can bring it to a close. But we must have dessert. We must give the toast. And we must wish everyone well and a pleasant holiday ahead. So done eating. Don't forget to close your be at 6:30. Use your napkins. Make sure you have a little wine in your glass for the toast. Okay, I need your attention, please. Can I have your attention, please? Now, if you all remember, when I showed, can I have your attention, please? I know we're eating. When I showed you the diagram earlier on for a formal dining placement, your dessert cutlery ideally would be above your charger plate, above your place setting. Sometimes your dessert cutlery is brought along with your dessert. Like, that's what would be happening this evening. So when you get your dessert, you will get your dessert spoon and you're going to get your dessert fork. Yes? So I'm going to show you, I'm going to be at the table and I'm going to show you how to use your dessert spoon and fork because we are having ice cream and cake.
I need all of you to pay attention. So when the dessert comes, you know what to do. Okay, do I have your attention? Okay, if you just look to your screens, my demonstration will be projected onto the screens so you can see how you're going to eat your desserts this evening. Okay, those of you paying attention, can you all look at your screens, please? So I have my dessert spoon in my right hand, and I have my dessert fork in my left hand. So what I'm going to do now is to take a little piece of cake, a little bit of the ice cream. I'm going to use my fork to push the ice cream onto my plate, onto my spoon. So I'm going to demonstrate that again. I would like your attention. Please look at your screens. So when your dessert comes out, you know how to eat your dessert properly. So I'm going to take a little bit of the cake. A little bit of the ice cream. I'm going to use my fork to push the cake onto my spoon. Then I'm going to lift that to my mouth. Please, can I have the dessert come out now? I can have your attention, please. You can pay attention to the screens. Because we have ice cream, the ice cream is likely to melt very quickly. So when you do get your dessert, this is how to handle it. You can either use your spoon, you can use your spoon alone, but it's always best when you use your spoon and your fork. I hope you all can see me. You can? Fantastic. So please, if you have your dessert, please have your spoon in your right hand and your dessert fork in your left hand. If you are paying attention, your dessert spoon is in your right hand and your dessert fork in your left hand. You use the fork to move the cake and the ice cream onto your spoon. don't forget bite-sized portions. If you're paying attention, when you have finished with your dessert spoon and fork, same way, you put them together and you close them, place them in the center of your plate. Yes, so just like that, the spoon on the right and the fork on the left, and you put that in the center of your plate.
Please make sure you're seated at all times, no moving about.
But it had some ice cream, so did you see? Yes, yeah, you saw. So your spoon right hand and your fork in your left hand. Perfect. So you use the fork to take a little bit of the cake, a little bit of the ice cream. You push everything onto the spoon and then you lift to your mouth. Yeah, so what it does is it prevents you from having to lift, you know, when you have food on your plate and you can't get it with your spoon and you are struggling, it prevents you having to lift your plate to do this. That's not proper. So you need to write everything on there. Then, yeah? Get dessert cutlery. Come in first, yeah? Hey, we're going to be having the toast shortly. While our dessert is coming out, I need 3 volunteers who are going to give a toast. Who would be giving a toast this evening? You? Okay, I have the first volunteer. What level? Yes, sir. Okay, my first volunteer to give a toast this evening is a year 7. I need someone from year 10. I'm going all the way to year 10. You, year 10? Thank you. I have a volunteer for year 10. I need someone from year 9. I need someone from year 9 for the toast. You? Thank you very much. I have year 9. Let me take someone from year 8. We are going to make this really quick. Year 8. I need a representative from year 8 to give a toast. Anybody from year 8? Year 8. I have year 10. I have year 7. Year 8. You? Or year 8? Do I have a representative? Do I have someone? Year 8. You? Year 8? Yes, I have year 7. I want year 8. I have year 8, perfect. So I have where's my representative from year 7? Okay. Everybody, can I have your can we keep it down? If not, we're not going to enjoy this session. Everyone. Can we keep the noise?
Can you keep the noise down now?
Yes, thank you. Let's keep it down. If not, we're not going to be able to hear your classmates. Can we take
if
it down
hear,
even more?
If I hear anyone talking, you will go to the stage and kneel down. Can you keep it down now?
Please let this bit of...
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Keep it down.
Thank you very much. So I have my representative from year 7. What's your name?
Divine from year 7,
please. Ifai from year 7. Please put your hands together for Ifai. And you must clap properly because they volunteered. So where's my representative from year 8? I had a representative from year 8. I had someone already. No one? Okay. Year 8? You? Okay. I have my representative from year 8. What's your name?
Efosa Michelle Bonsa.
Please put your hands together for her. Put your hands together. They volunteered to do the hard work. Present from year 9. I had a representative from year 9. Was it you? Please come out. Put your hands together for her. Representative from year 10. The ladies are representing tonight. I have my representative from year 10 is a gentleman. Another lady, what's happening to the gentleman? I have year 7, where's year 8? I have year 8, I have year 7, year 7, year 8, year 9, and year 10. Okay. Okay, can we keep it down? If not, let's take it down. Let's take it down. I can hear some of you talking. You don't want me to have to call Mr. College. Okay, we're not doing the toast again. Can we take it down so we can hear them? Okay. Now, usually when you have a formal evening, at the end when you get to desserts, that's when someone gets up to give a toast. It's usually during dessert time. That's the less formal part of a main event, of a formal dinner or a formal event. Yes? So we are going to listen to him.
Your toast is still.
Now, when they say keep it quiet, they mean keep it quiet. Okay? It is very disrespectful when the host is trying to address you all and you keep talking.
Okay. Are we good to go? Okay. Divine is ready to make his toast. And please, once he's done, don't forget, you're going to raise your glass. And don't forget, we're not clinking, we're just raising our glasses. Yes? So, Divine, take it away. Please, sit.
I would like to propose a toast to all the graduates who graduated from this school, Edward College. Thank you.
Put your hands together. To all the graduates who graduated today, raise your glasses to them. Wonderful. And then you can take a sip. So please put your hands together for Divine. A round of applause for Divine. He's toasting all the graduates for today. So we have
Ephusa.
She's going to be sharing her toast now. So please pay attention.
I'd like you guys to have a toast about the life and events of Edru College. Thank you.
Please raise your glasses to all the
students from year 7, year 8, year 9.
To all the students of Edgewood College, raise your glasses. That involves every single person here. Raise your glasses to all the students of Edgewood College. Please put your hands together for Ephusa.
Am I correct?
Please put your hands together for her. Thank you very much. Please put your hands together for Janice. Don't forget, they volunteered. Okay?
I'd like to propose it.
Did you hear you?
I'd like to toast to Edgewood College. I'd like to toast to Edgewood College.
Okay, Janice would like to toast to Edgewood College. So everyone raise your glasses to Edgewood College. Put your hands together for her. There's nothing wrong in clapping, so keep clapping to encourage them. Obiageli is next, so please encourage her as she comes.
I'd like to make a toast because we come to the end of the school year.
To the end of the school year. Obiageli is toasting to the end of the school year. So raise your glasses, everyone. I'm sure you are happy to have made it to the end of the school year. Thank you very much, Obiageli. Please put your hands together for all our volunteers this evening. All our volunteers, thank you very much. Now, I know some of us are still tucking into our dessert. It's still coming round. And we're going to be closing the evening very soon. In another 10 minutes or so. So please, let's have the dessert coming out. If you've noticed, those of you who have received your dessert, you have a dessert spoon and fork. Your dessert spoon is in your right hand, and your dessert fork is in your left hand. Now the tines of the fork are facing your plate, just like you had the dinner fork. Yes, so you use it to put the cake and the ice cream onto your spoon. You use that to place the ice cream and the cake onto your spoon, and then you lift your spoon to your mouth. It's easier when you have a spoon and a fork. And that prevents you from having to lift your plate to the side to scrape your dessert onto your cutlery. So it's always best to have dessert spoon and dessert fork. If you are having just ice cream, you would use just your spoon. And if you were having just cake, you could get away with using either your spoon or the fork. But when you have something like ice cream or you have custard, it's always easy to use your fork and your spoon just to navigate. If you were having like an apple pie and custard, you could use both pieces of cutlery. Or you could use just your spoon, dessert spoon. So it depends on what you're having for dessert. So don't forget, if you've had your dessert, you close your cutlery as well at 6:30 with your spoon on the right-hand side and your fork on the left-hand side. And when we're done this evening, your napkin, you're going to leave the table. So don't forget, I want to believe your napkin is still on your lap. So what you do when you are ready to leave your table, you just pick up your napkin and leave it loosely folded on the left-hand side. You don't need to fold it neatly or anything like that. because you need to let people know, or the waiter know, that it has been used. So you leave it loosely, lift it off your lap, and just place it on the table. So we will be leaving our tables in the next 5 minutes or so when we're done with our dessert. The desserts are coming out. Again, if you feel comfortable just using your dessert spoon, you can go ahead and use the spoon alone. If you need the fork to help you navigate, you can have the fork in your left hand and the spoon in your right hand. So I know we have the dessert coming out. If anyone has any questions to ask, there's been a lot of information here this evening, but the honest truth is, you might not have learned everything this evening. Practice, it takes time. Practice makes perfect. So you're going to have to do this over and over again. Now, with how many weeks of holiday? About 6 weeks, if not more, you can practice at home. If you're going on holiday, you can practice. If you're going to a restaurant, you can practice. So practice makes perfect. So whatever you've learned today, you can perfect it with your meal times at home and restaurants that you might visit over the holiday. Okay, so I'm going to go to one or two tables, and I just want to demonstrate. Anyone wants me to show them? Sure. Who has received? Sorry? Yes, you have a question. Drinks with straws. Okay, he asked a good question. He says, what about drinking with straws? Now, when normally you drink from your glass, when it's an informal event, can use a straw. Yes? So I don't expect you to use a straw at an event like this that is very formal. Yes? So the best thing is to drink from your glass. The proper thing would be to drink from your glass. But like I say, when you're having a barbecue or you're at McDonald's or KFC, you can ask for a straw and it's okay then. But not for a formal event like this. Thank you for that question. That was a very good question. Anyone to use both pieces of cutlery? I can show you. See, some people have closed the cutlery here. Nice, at 6:30. Perfect. The spoon on the right hand side and the fork on the left hand side. I see, yes, this table. I think you must have had your dessert first. Perfect. This table has perfect score. Yes, everyone has closed their dessert cutlery. Yes, your spoon on the right-hand side and your fork on the left-hand side. Nicely done. So I hope going forward, if you have to dine formally, you know what to do. This table. Don't worry, your dessert is coming. For those of you who haven't received yet,
Remind all students that the presentation is still going on. When you are talking over the presenter, it is disrespectful. Okay? And at the end of the day, learning will take place. So again, show respect. The presenter is presenting, you keep quiet and you listen.
Within, I know we're almost done, but I need a volunteer. I hope the cameraman will pick me. Usually when we dine formally like this, you have gentlemen, you have ladies. The helps the lady, the gentleman helps the lady to sit properly. So I need a volunteer. Just with a seat here, chair here. I need a gentleman who considers themselves a gentleman. I need a gentleman and I need a lady. Please. Quickly, just to demonstrate how you help a lady into her seat. Thank you very much. Please put your hands together. He's a perfect gentleman. Thank you. And please put your hands together for her. You did volunteer, so give them a round of applause. You can do a lot better than that. If not, we're not doing this. You don't want us to do this. I need you to encourage me, encourage them. Fantastic. So, I hope you can see me. Okay, so, what we are trying to do here, the proper thing is, dining as a gentleman, you have other ladies around you, you can help them to their seat. Yes, especially the lady sitting to your right, you can help her in. So, you're going to demonstrate how to help her. So, what if the chair is in? The chair is in. Yes, so what you're going to do, you're going to pull it out. She'll be standing next to the chair. I hope you can all see the screen. She'll be standing next to the chair. So you pull the chair out. You watch the chair out. And she moves in. She'll move in. And as she moves in and she tries to sit, you lower the chair. And then she moves in. So let's do that again. So did we get that? Are you all ready to see it now? You're not ready? Are we ready? I need a yes. Are we ready? Exactly. So let's see this gentleman here help this lovely lady into her seat. Okay, so the chair is in. So he's going to pull the chair out. She's going to move into space. And as she sits down, he puts the chair in. Then puts it get up a bit and then pushes it in. Perfect. Put your hands together for him and for her. So the next time, thank you very much, both of you. So the next time you find yourselves in that situation, it's an opportunity to be the perfect gentleman. Now you're getting older. It's the proper thing to do, and it's what would be expected of you. So whether it's your mom, it's your sister, whether it's someone that you're good, we're all going to get married here someday. Whether it's someone you are going to end up getting married, you have to be courteous. Yeah, for the men here. Okay, so it's only proper to extend that courtesy to the ladies around you. So that was very well done. A round of applause for them one more time. Thank you very much. If anybody has any questions, I'm sure we'll be done in another 5 minutes. If anybody has any questions, you can ask. Don't forget to close your cutlery at 6:30. I think we've made the best effort with the dessert. Spoons on the right, forks on the left, together at the center, 6:30. Well done, everybody. Don't forget to practice over the holiday. Practice makes perfect. You can even organize a small dinner party at home for your friends or for your family, and show your friends and your other family members the proper way to die, because you have learned a thing or two here this evening.
All right, can we give Mr. Musa a resounding round of applause? I think it was a fantastic presentation. How many of you agree with me? If you agree with me, give her another round of applause. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
We're going to round up now. And I'm going to call on our executive director for some last words before we round up the formal dining for 2023. Again, well done to everyone for being here. And I'm sure you have learned a lot. And I'm going to be asking some questions in a few minutes to see how much you have learned.
Thank you.
But let's put our hands together for our executive director.
Till tomorrow, I still struggle with one or two things, and I always look for, because of that, I look forward to a formal dining event at Edgewood College so that I can sharpen that skill, right? Just now, I was trying to show someone how to use a dessert fork, and I said, oh, yeah. She said right or left, you know? So, you know, it's important to know these things, because one day, you will be called upon. It might be surprising to demonstrate the skills, and it would be very sad if you came to a school like this that pays attention to such things and you did not get that skill. Because, you know, year in, year out, you bring her, all you have to do is pay attention so that you can learn. And it's only someone who's left the face of the earth that stops learning. Every single day, we are all learning one new thing or the other. So this is what we brought to you today. I hope you find them, the instructions valuable, and that you take them to another level in your lives. Thank you all very much. God bless you.
Okay, so we're going to round up, and I'm going to call on the students to do the closing prayer. Dessert, and for some of you, your parents are already waiting. Okay, so I'm going to call. Okay. Let's clap for him.
In Jesus' name, Father, thank you for giving us all here today. Thank you that we have learned valuable lessons that we gave to impact in our lives. Father, I pray that as we go on our journey, shall cover us with the blood of Jesus. Father, no harm shall come upon any of us in Jesus' name. Father, guide and guide us in everything you do in Jesus' name. Father, I pray that no harm shall, I pray that we shall follow the right path in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I pray.
Teacher, for the prayer, can we share the grace? And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen. The college confession: for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set us free from the law of sin and death. And so sin shall not have dominion over us, for the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells inside of us and quickens our mortal bodies to the glory of his holy name. Amen. Please remain seated. We will call you if your parents are here, and then you can make your way out. So please remain seated.
Toluwa, ti oluwa limi kola oni, ti oluwa limi kola oni, ifi akana.